Let me guess. Lineage traced back to the great Hayden himself? Let's see here. Y'all got soul. Oh, yes, soul. A raison d'être? Delicious. My sisters say whoever you got playing the keys got more funk in his pinky. But I told her that ain't funk. That's classical. Yes, indeed. That must be most exacerbating. Classical music has been known since the time of the early explorers. Funk, by contrast, is an entirely modern conceit, and you'll find none of that here. Funk, as they say, is for the layperson. Now, let's hear another one of those soulful cants.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Jarva Mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this. A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently, that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human psyche.
Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement. Local authorities are urging the public to conserve water and reduce the burden on the city during this water shortage. Consider installing a low-flush toilet, cut back on watering the lawn, and shower with a friend whenever possible. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're listening to Second Moon, the station for the cultural sophisticate who doesn't fear extending their ears to the more challenging sphere of the classical genre. Let us move now from the musical page to the literary. Here we have some perfectly anguishing correspondence from a listener. My dear Professor Hornbuckle, whereas I make no apology for my erudite, modesty demands that I prevaricate against the title. I am but a humble devotee of the form, and all my expertise derives merely from a life devoted to the gentle arts. Though I do thank you for the honor, but I digest to continue. Professor Hornbuckle, as a traveler from my homeland, I long to hear a tune that speaks to the anguish of my road-weary soul. There now, my good fellow, chin up, as it were. No need to wallow in sediment. Leave that to those poet chaps, eh? Here's a tune just for you, and I do hope it provides your aching spirit some modest desolation.
Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local economy.
That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
This is an emergency broadcast to all citizens.
Increasing areas of forest are being engulfed by flames. The thick smoke rising from the fire makes the air dangerous to breathe. Citizens are advised to vacate any premises near the fires and remain at a safe distance until emergency services manage to get the fires under control.
Thank you.
That was truly superfluous. Masterful counterpart. You're listening to Second Moon Radio, the station of levitated tastes. Don't touch that dial.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human psyche.
Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this.
Thank you.
You're listening to Second Moon, the epitome of classical listening at home, or wherever you roam.
We've recently been having what some are calling the worst kind of luck there is. That's right. Today, we are talking about the increased likelihood that you'll die.
That's not exactly what an increased death rate measures.
Either way, if everybody is dying, that gives me the creeps.
Now that's a wild overstatement. Are you trying to make people panic?
Pam, did you say panic? She said panic. The death rate is skyrocketing. We've got to get out of here.
You go. I'll stay and clear up the mess. We'll be back after this. Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local economy.
That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin.
The Fire and Rescue Service reports that fires are currently spreading in the nearby forest. The billowing clouds of smoke pose a serious health risk to anyone nearby. At this time, all citizens in the affected area are instructed to immediately move to a safe distance until the situation is under control.
Thank you.
Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive, and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're listening to Second Moon Radio with J. Thomas Hornbuckle, and we're pervading some of the finest classical music on the air. Keep that dial right here.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this. Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda.
Thank you.
How delightful! Another letter from our erstwhile listeners. What's up, honey? Me and my sister love you. Oh, that's nice. Y'all got clarinets and violins, but you got something most music these days ain't. Oh, let me guess. Lineage traced back to the great Haydn himself? Let's see here. Y'all got soul. Oh, yeah. Soul. A raison d'être? Delicious. My sisters say whoever you got playing the keys got more funk in his pinky. But I told her that ain't funk. That's classical. Yes, indeed. That must be most exacerbating. Classical music has been known since the time of the early explorers. Funk, by contrast, is an entirely modern conceit, and you'll find none of that here. Funk, as they say, is for the layperson. Now, let's hear another one of those soulful cants.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda.
Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local economy.
That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human psyche.
Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
This is an emergency broadcast to all citizens. Increasing areas of forest are being engulfed by flames. The thick smoke rising from the fire makes the air dangerous to breathe. Citizens are advised to vacate any premises near the fires and remain at a safe distance until emergency services manage to get the fires under control.
Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement. Local authorities are urging the public to conserve water and reduce the burden on the city during this water shortage. Consider installing a low-flush toilet. Cut back on watering the lawn, and shower with a friend whenever possible. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're tuned in to Second Moon, the channel where the classics never grow old.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda.
We've recently been having what some are calling the worst kind of luck there is. That's right. Today, we are talking about the increased likelihood that you'll die.
That's not exactly what an increased death rate measures.
Either way, if everybody is dying, that gives me the creeps.
That's a wild overstatement. Are you trying to make people panic?
Pam, did you say panic? She said panic. The death rate is skyrocketing. We've got to get out of here.
You go. I'll stay and clear up the mess. We'll be back after this.